Now we can discuss with the word problems. Okay. Fourth question. The sum of the reciprocals of Rahman's age in years 3 years ago and 5 years from now is 1/3. Sum of the reciprocals of Rahman's ages 3 years ago and 5 years from now is 1/3. Find his percentage. So here first we want to take present age as x. Okay. So let the present age of Rahman be x years. Then here two conditions are there, or two cases are there, that is 3 years ago and 5 years from now. So 3 years ago, what will be Rahman's age? X minus 3 years. Okay. Then what will be his age 5 years from now? It will be x plus 5 years. Okay. Before 3 years, x minus 3. After 5 years, x plus 5. That we should find first. Present age x. Before 3 years, x minus 3 years. After 5 years, x plus 5 years. Then what is given in the question? Sum of the reciprocals of Rahman's ages 3 years ago and 5 years from now is 1/3. So their reciprocals sum of 1/(x-3) and 1/(x+5) equal 1/3. Okay, sum of reciprocals of. So here we can write 1/(x-3) plus 1/(x+5) equal 1/3 according to the question. Then as last question, we can cross multiply. Then x plus 5 into 1, x plus 5, x minus 3 into 1, x minus 3. Here plus symbol, so no need to put separate brackets. Okay, if you put the bracket, no problem. Then x minus 3 into x plus 5, multiply the denominators. Then equal 1/3 itself. Then x plus x is 2x. 5 minus 3 is plus 2, positive 2. So we will get 2x plus 2 by, here we can use the identity or direct multiplication. Here x minus 3 into x plus 5 equal x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. So x square plus negative 3 plus 5, that is positive 2. So plus 2x. Then negative 3 into 5 minus 50. Anyway, you can expand. Okay. As last question, we can multiply them as direct way. Otherwise, using identity. Then equal 1/3. Then again, we want to transpose this 3 to here. This x square plus 2x minus 15 to right side. Then 3 into 2x plus 2 become 3 into 2x, 6x plus 3 into 2, 6. Equal, here we multiply by 1, so that itself we will get. So x square plus 2x minus 15 itself. Then transpose this to here. Then what we will get? X square plus 2x minus 15 minus 6x minus 6 equals 0. Then 2x minus 6x will be minus 4x. Minus 15 minus 6 will be minus 21. Okay, that will be equal 0. All the terms we transpose to LHS, so it will be 0 on the right side. Okay, now we got the equation x square minus 4x minus 21. Anyway, any method, by using any method you can find the roots. Here I used the factorization method, splitting the middle term method. Okay, so here 4x, I need to get minus 4x. We need to split. Okay. For that, we need to find AC. Here, what is A? 1. C is negative 21. So, AC is negative 21 into 1, negative 21. Then, B is negative 4. So, here, product is negative means one of the number is positive, other will be negative. Then, B is negative means biggest will be negative, smallest will be positive. Okay. Product negative means two numbers having different symbols. B is negative means among two numbers, biggest will be negative, then smallest will be positive. Then this 4 will be the difference of two numbers. then 21 will be the product of the same two numbers. So first we want to check which all products will be 21. So 3 into 7 is 21. Then 7 minus 3 is 4. Difference is 4. So 7 minus 3 is 4. 7 into 3 is 21. Biggest is 7. So its symbol will be negative. Smallest is 3. Its symbol will be positive. So here we can split that as x square minus 7x plus 3x minus 21 equal 0. Last year you already studied 4 conditions or 4 types of methods to find the factors or factorization method or which is splitting the middle term method. 4 cases are there that we already studied in detail in last year. So you just revise that. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can send the mail. Then x square minus 7x plus 3x minus 21 equals 0. We just change this minus 4x as minus 7x plus 3x. Then take the common factor outside. From this group, x is the common factor. From this group, 3 is the common factor. Then again, we got x minus 7 as the common factor that we should take outside. Then which is remain x plus 3. So x plus 3 into x minus 7 equals 0. So x plus 3 is 0 or x minus 7 is 0. This is the method of factorization. So x equal negative 3 or x equal 7. Transpose them. This 3 to here then minus 3. This 7 to here positive 7. So x equal 7 or negative 3. In the word problems, we check whether the two values are acceptable or not. Here we take x as the age, present age of Rahman. We took x as present age of Rahman. Age cannot be negative. So we should write here negative 3 can be rejected since the age cannot be negative. So here what is the answer? Hence the present age of Rahman is x equal 7 years. Okay. Why we reject the one of the value, that reason you should write. Otherwise, both are acceptable. Clear. So, here negative 3 can be rejected because age cannot be negative. So, here what is the answer? Rahman's present age is 7 years. Now, the question number 5. In a class test, sum of Shefali's marks in maths and English is 30. Sum of the marks in maths and English is 30. Had she got 2 marks more in maths and 3 marks less in English, the product of their marks would have been 210. Find her marks in the two subjects. That is the question. Okay. In mathematics and English, the sum of that marks is 30. Had she got 2 marks more in maths and 3 marks less in English, then the product will be 210. So, find her marks in two subjects. So, here we can take what is her marks in maths, x. Okay. Then, what is the relation between marks in maths and English? Sum of the marks in maths and English is 30. So, if the marks in maths is x, means marks in English will be what? 30 minus x. Because sum of these two will be 30, no? So one of them is x, means other one will be 30 minus x. 30 minus x, order has importance. No need to write x minus 30. 30 is the total, so 30 minus x itself. Okay, then what they given? If the marks, 2 marks more in maths and 3 marks less in English. 2 marks more in maths means x plus 2. 3 marks less in English means 30 minus x minus 3. Then their product is, so this we can multiply. Then what we will get as the answer? 210. Okay. Then we need to expand this brackets. X into 27, 27x. Then x into x, negative x square. 2 into 27, positive 54. 2 into negative x minus 2x. This is equal to 110. Then 27x. First we can write the term with x square. So negative x square. Then 27x minus 2x like terms. So we can combine 27 minus 2, 25. So plus 25x. Then 54. This 210 we can transpose to LHS. So minus 210 equals 0. Okay. Then 54 minus 210. What it will be? Negative 156. But in this step we change all the symbols. Because if the symbol of x square is negative, it is some confusion. There will be some confusion, or it is not a standard form. You can take it as negative also, but if x square is negative, that all the symbols you can change to get x square as positive. Okay, so here x square is negative, so we can change all the symbols. So negative x square become positive x square. Then plus 25x become minus 25x. Here this answer will be minus 156. So it will be changed as plus 156 equal 0. Okay. Now we can do the cross. Which method? Factorization method or quadratic formula. Any method you can use. Here I use factorization method. Okay. So we need to. What we need? We need to split the middle term. Minus 25x. Okay. So what is the rule? AC. 1 into 156. 156. Then negative 25 is B. Product is positive means two numbers having the same symbol. Here B is negative means both having negative symbol. Sum of two numbers 25. Product of two numbers is 156. Okay. So here which are the two numbers? 13 and 12. If you have any confusion to take these numbers, then it is easy to do that by which method? Which method? Quadratic formula using or applying quadratic formula if the method is not mentioned in the question. So you can use that method also. Quadratic formula also you can use. If it is, if that is easy, that you can use. If it is easy, this you can use. Okay, no problem. Here I use factorization method. Okay. So 13x minus 12x. We can split that into minus 13 and minus 12. Then grouping them. So x square minus 13x in one group. Minus 12x minus 156 equal 0. Then take the common factor from both or two groups. Then in the first group, x is the common factor. So x minus 13 remaining. Then second one, minus 12 is the common factor. So remaining x minus 13. This is equal 0. Then again, x minus 13 is the common factor that we can take outside. Then x minus 12 is remaining. So x minus 2 into x minus 13 equals 0. So x minus 12 equals 0, then x equals 12. Or x minus 13 is equal 0, then x equal 30. So here we got x is 12 and x is 13. Both are positive values. Here we took marks in maths as x. So it will be 12 or 13. So if marks in maths x equal 12, then what will be the mark in English? In English, 30 minus x. 30 minus 12 is 18. If the marks is marks in max x equal 13, then marks in English will be what? 30 minus 13 equal 17. So if the marks of max 12, then marks in English 18. If marks in max is 13, then marks in English is 17. Both values are acceptable, so we can't reject anyone. Both you should write in words. Word problems answer you want to conclude in words itself, then only you will get the full mark.